Welcome to Microsoft Mechanics. Coming up on the show, we'll look at updated collaboration experiences across SharePoint and OneDrive, including mobile and web experiences for helping you work with and share your team's files. Recently launched improvements to the SharePoint team site, allowing you to easily create a home for your Office 365 group's content, cross-platform mobile apps to help you connect with your team members and content while on the go, and keep watching as we look at what's coming next for SharePoint. I'm joined today by Adam Harmetz, Group Program Manager in the SharePoint Engineering Team. Welcome.
Great to be on the show today, Jeremy.
So your team's been working on some really great updates for SharePoint and OneDrive for Business, really delivering on what we call the mobile and intelligent intranet. We saw a lot of that in May, but what are some of the capabilities that people are starting to see light up in their Office 365 tenants?
Yeah, we've delivered a lot since May. We launched a new home for SharePoint on the web. We've since shipped the SharePoint iOS app. We refreshed lists and integrated them with Microsoft Flow and Power Apps. We made it easy to author a SharePoint page that looks great on mobile, and we recently hooked up all these team site capabilities to Office 365 groups. You know, we've really focused on making the SharePoint team site simple and easy to use, and a great addition to any Office 365 group. And today, let's take a look at how all this comes together. So I'm gonna start on my mobile device, because I think it'll be a great way to show just how approachable Team Sites is. I'm using an iPhone here, and what I'm gonna show you has also been built for Android and Windows 10 mobile.
Okay.
You know, the scenario here is, let's imagine we're working on a project to build a loyalty program for a fictional company called Contoso Clothing.
Okay.
We work with somebody named Mark, and Mark has been working on a document, and OneDrive has just notified me using an in-app native mobile notification that he shared the document with me.
And great power of the integration as a mobile and native app.
Yeah, exactly. So I'll go ahead and take a look at the OneDrive app. You can see that not only does it allow me to look at my personal files, it also allows me to look at my group and SharePoint team site files as well. So if I click into this loyalty program, you can really see that SharePoint has been integrated, and OneDrive is really a file explorer for all my files, no matter where they're stored. I can do really cool things. I can peek into a particular library. I can open a particular document. It opens in rich PowerPoint. I can select a couple documents or files and take them offline. Or I could take a file and get a quick link or invite people to it. First, if I copy this link, I'll be sure that anybody in Contoso has the ability to take a look at it.
So really a great tool to be able to get to all your files for a team site or through OneDrive for Business. But I know you've also made some great updates to the SharePoint mobile app that we released back in June.
Yeah, let's go ahead and take a look.
Okay.
So from the OneDrive app, I'll click on Open Site, and I'm taken to the home for my Office 365 groups, content, and people. Mm-hmm. And we're really focused on making this a great way to bring together all the resources for the team. Here we lead with something called news. So I've been working on this roadshow deck, and I really wanted to make sure we're spotlighted to the team, so I put it at the top of news. Below that, we have activity powered by the Office Graph. It remembers things that I've been to before, as well as things that are popular that other people have seen, and show them to me right there.
Okay.
As I click on the nav to the site, we can see all the team's resources right there, the Power BI dashboard, or this team charter page that I created using the new SharePoint page authoring technology. It really allowed me to create a page that looks great on mobile. So for instance, I've added a little bit of context at the top. I've embedded the PowerPoint presentation I used to kick off the team. Our CEO was kind enough to record a video that I've embedded here and can play right in line. And our data scientist team has a Power BI dashboard of customer data that I've embedded and can play with right from the mobile app.
Very cool.
Yeah, and the last thing here is a feed of all the documents that are important to the Contoso loyalty program right here, so the page stays up to date.
So really great use during the power of SharePoint right from your phone. But I know people have been asking us about lists and when we get to support lists with the mobile app.
Yeah, exactly. So right here we have a list. It's a departmental contact list.
Okay.
So as you can imagine, for the Contoso loyalty program, we're putting together people from all various departments, and you can see who the primary contacts for each department are right here. One of the things we've done since we shipped the iOS app in June is add list editing. So for instance, I can go into the business development team, click edit, and for instance, if Jeremy isn't a good backup for you, I can go add somebody named Alyssa, maybe. As a backup, I can hit save. And just like that, we've edited a list item from the SharePoint mobile app.
So really productive right from your mobile phone. But I know beyond even mobile, we've done a ton of work in terms of the browser experiences to make sure that you're productive while you're at your PCs. And for that, I want to switch over to my PC and show a couple of demos.
Sounds great.
So here I'm in my group's conversation view, and I can see all the great conversations going on the team for the loyalty program that you've invited me to. Thank you very much for that. I can see my calendar, I can see the notebook, planner, all the things that we've not only talked about on shows on the mechanics before, but also some great new things like files. And I'm gonna go ahead and click on the new experience there for files, because that's gonna take me right into this great new SharePoint experience to be able to browse all the documents from the document library. And here you can see I've got some files that are pinned up on the top, the loyalty program roadshow deck, so my team can get to that very quickly and very easily. And I also see all the things that are added below in terms of all the rest of the files in that library. I'm going to go ahead and add a link, because this is something else that we can do, is really link to external content. And for this, I'm going to add a link to a YouTube channel, the Microsoft Mechanics one. Let's give that a name.
Yeah, this is great, because it allows you to bring all the content to the team related all in one place, even files that aren't stored in the library.
And once that pops up, you can see it here on the bottom of the page, so that's something that my team can get to really quickly. Now, one other thing that's really cool in terms of some of the newest updates here is I can take that and also give it a tile view. So I can not only look at the list of things there, but I can get a rich preview of all of the different contents of that library right here in the tile view. And one really cool new addition is the ability to look at photos in a slideshow mode. So here we have some trip report photos, and I can see thumbnails of those photos, but to really see the power of how those photos actually look in full screen, I can get a great new experience here and really thumb through all of those very quickly on this device to really have a nice, rich content consumption experience for those photos. But beyond even what we see here, sharing's also gotten much easier in some of the work that your team's done. I'm going to hop back into documents. What I want to do is actually take one of my documents and share it. So I'm going to select that document, and I'm going to go ahead and say get a link. And once I grab that link, it's already here. I'm going to go ahead and put that into our conversation view. So now I'm hopped back into conversations. I'm going to go ahead and reply to Lincoln here, who wanted an answer about some of the incentives. And I'll show him that we've got some great new content here for him to review. We'll go ahead and put that link back in. And the nice thing is that Outlook, whether I'm in the conversation view or in Outlook on the web, it'll give me a nice, rich preview of that file right there from my messages.
Yeah, just a great way the suite is coming together to help solve collaboration problems.
And Adam, your team's also built out some great experiences beyond just files that can really take advantage of SharePoint and Office 365 groups. Can you give us a look?
Yeah. So let's switch to my device here, and we can see a team site for the loyalty program group. This is the same team site that you were just looking at, that the documents were from, as well as the same team site we were looking at on the mobile phone. You can see that the header here tells me it's a group, and I can access my group conversations and group membership, group metadata, the logo for the team site in the group, and the same navigation elements that you saw before on the phone appear right here too. The home by default leads with news and activity, just like in the mobile app. News is a chance to spotlight content, and activities is the office graph to keep me updated about what's going on.
Right.
Of course, you can edit the homepage if you need to as well.
Yep.
I'd like to talk about news a little more, because I think it's a great way that we've been able to use the page authoring technology in a new way. I think it'll make it a lot easier to create pages and show the value that a team site can provide.
And it's something brand new.
Yeah, exactly. So I'm going to go ahead and add a page. So let's suppose here that you and I were on a trip to a retail conference or something like that. We want to come back, and we've written up a PowerPoint of lessons learned and take a couple photos. Let's package it all together and share it out to the team by creating a news post.
Okay.
So let's say Woodgrove Retail Conference, trip report. I'll go ahead and type some text here, copy-pasting from the clipboard. I can do whatever formatting I need to really get my point across, like bolding that right there.
Mm-hmm.
Then I click this plus button. You can see our web part gallery. This is a really powerful way where you can bring together a bunch of content or processes or web parts and add them to the page, really make the page come alive.
Make it much more robust. Very cool.
Yeah, absolutely. So for instance, right here, I'll add a document because we were working on a lessons learned PowerPoint.
Mm-hmm.
It's in my recent files right here, so I can select it. You get a full PowerPoint preview right here where I can scroll through the PowerPoint. Let me add a little more text talking about how the showroom floor was awesome, and I'm going to include an image of the showroom floor right here so you can see another web part, like the image web part. And just like that, you see the page is immediately available right on the home page. And over time, we'll add stuff like mobile notifications and email sharing, so it'll just be a really great way of getting pages created and keeping a team together.
Definitely. And by the way, if you are a SharePoint developer, we've built a great new SharePoint framework where you can build out custom web parts using common web development tools and a brand new tool chain. For more details on that, we've actually filmed a show with Dan Kogan for Microsoft Mechanics.
Yeah, and if you've built SharePoint web parts or anything like that, they'll appear right in that gallery that we were just looking at.
Let's move on. Using Microsoft Flow and Power Apps, you can be a hero and automate repetitive tasks and organize how your team gets work done.
Yeah. So to set that up, I'll show you a list that I have right here. it's the rewards brainstorm list. So, you know, when we establish this loyalty program, we need to give perks to our most loyal customers. And so we just had a SharePoint list here that brings together a bunch of ideas for the type of perks that we should be giving out.
Really cool. And I know that you've also built a power app so that anybody can actually add to and contribute to that list, right?
Yeah, exactly, because we want everybody in the company to be able to participate.
And I've got one of those actually running on this phone here, and this is an Android phone. So if I go ahead and click on our Contoso Club, it's got a great new power app for me to actually submit and look at different ideas. So here, once I'm into the Contoso Club app, I can also see I've got a couple of options here. I can either browse for ideas or submit an idea. So here I can go ahead and browse at the current ideas that have been submitted by other members of the team.
Yeah, and that's showing the data from the SharePoint list in the mobile app.
And here I can vote it up, for example, but I actually want to submit an idea because I've got a great idea for another giveaway.
Yeah.
So we'll go ahead and add free socks.
Free socks are an awesome potential perk.
Definitely. So we got our free socks. We'll go ahead and make that a free product, and we'll go ahead and hit submit. Now, once I do that, it's going to show up in your list, right?
Yeah, exactly. So it's, once again, a way that we can leverage the brain power of everybody in the corporation by using Power Apps to collect data and put it in a SharePoint list.
But I had another idea, though. As I was launching this app, I saw something on the homepage. It'd be really great if we could actually edit the app and have a way to contact us, maybe via email. And could you add that to the Power App?
Yeah, absolutely. Adding new functionality to the Power App is super easy. There's a visual designer. So if I'm back on here in the Power Apps Design Studio, you can see the app that we were just looking at. Here's the one where it's showing all the SharePoint list data. And you said we're going to add the email address of the group to the home screen. That's really easy to do. So I'll go ahead and insert a new text box. Go ahead and say that people should be contacting us using the group's email address. Format it to be the right size. Maybe change the font to match what's on the screen. And just like that, I made an update to the app. As I hit save, that app will be automatically published out to all employees. It's really easy to rapidly develop and keep these applications updated.
And that looked really easy, but where does all that data go and how does it kind of flow into our system?
Yeah, let's take a look at how Microsoft Flow can make the review of all these new ideas really simple.
Okay.
So here's an email that was automatically generated when you submit an idea. It says who submitted the idea as well as what the idea was. And as a product owner, I can quickly say whether it's a duplicate or a good idea. I think new socks is a great idea, so I'm going to click on that. And just like that, right from mail, we've actually updated the SharePoint list with this. So let me go back to the list and see what's happened.
Okay.
Go ahead and click on this new view that I created that automatically groups by feasibility. And you can see this idea for free socks you submitted was tagged as a great idea because of the flow.
So there's definitely some workflow automation happening here under the covers. How does that work?
Yeah, let's go ahead and show. So we've integrated both Power Apps and Flow directly into the list. So that Power App that you saw before be created by creating Create an App. And for here, I'm going to go take a look at the flows that are already on this list by hitting See Your Flows. Let me show you how easy it is to set up this review process that we've just been looking at.
Okay.
I'll go ahead and edit this flow that's already on the list. And you can see a basic flow. When a new item is created, it says if the type of reward, which is pulling in metadata from the SharePoint list, is free product, then it's going to send me an email with a list of options. You can sort of see the options right there. So it's just really easy to have a visual designer go ahead and set this up. As soon as I hit Update Flow, it's live and running, and any new submissions to the Power App would automatically come flowed through and run through this process.
You can go beyond this. For example, if you wanted to have for a Twitter feed or some social feed come in for external submitters of ideas, that's something else you could build too, right?
Yeah, actually, we've even made that easy to set up. So if I go back to the list and hit Create Flow, you see we have these templates to make it really easy to get started.
Okay.
So the one that we were looking at before was to send a customized email when a new list item is created. That'll get me started real quick.
Right.
Or you can see the example here that you were just talking about. When a new tweet comes in from a specific hashtag, we can edit the SharePoint list as well. So this would be great for this scenario. Once we've launched the loyalty program, customers could submit reward ideas too via Twitter.
So a lot of really great updates in terms of what we can do on mobile and the web, automation of workflows. But where do you suggest people get started?
Yeah, it's easy. Just create a new team site. That'll give you an Office 365 group as well.
Okay.
So if I go to the new home for SharePoint on the web and hit Create Site, it takes me through a couple simple steps for creating a site. So I can give the site a name, which is going to create an Office 365 group with a particular email, I'm told. I can set some settings, add people to the group. And just like that, click Finish, and we're all done. We have a SharePoint team site along with an Office 365 group, and everything we showed today, you can start doing.
And vice versa, also if you create a group, it'll create a team site as we saw earlier with our groups view.
Yeah, absolutely, that's right. It's really important because there are no compromises or trade-offs about which way you do it. You get the same value either way. And of course, everything you build will be mobile and responsive and have the same capabilities we saw at the beginning of the video on your phone.
So really a lot of great updates that your team's built out, but where is all this going?
Yeah, there's a lot coming soon to expand collaboration and publishing experience across SharePoint and OneDrive. So we're working hard to deliver the next generation OneDrive Sync client on top of SharePoint team sites, including Office 365 groups. We'll expand team news that you saw today. We'll use the Office Graph to provide a stream of personalized important news from across all the sites and complement it with traditional corporate news articles. And we're going to make significant investments in publishing, focused on out-of-the-box experiences. So by publishing, I mean things like a publishing site, a dedicated site that allows you to broadcast out your message to the company, as well as deep analytics and insights investments so you can be confident that your message and content get to the right employees.
Thank you, Adam, for really a lot of great updates in SharePoint and more coming on the way.
Absolutely, and we couldn't do it without feedback from our community and customers. So if you use the SharePoint mobile app, go ahead and shake your phone to send us feedback, or you can use user voice to send us feedback about anything in the product.
And that's about all the time we have today, but keep checking back to Microsoft Mechanics as tech news breaks, and thanks for watching.